What do you get when you bring together world-class scientific research and the culinary arts? A sweeter, juicier North Carolina strawberry. Researchers with the NC State University Plants for Human Health Institute at the North Carolina Research Campus have joined forces with chefs at Johnson & Wales University in Charlotte to breed a better berry with a longer growing season. These experts hope the results are sweet for farmers' profits and consumers' palates.
This is a really exciting new partnership that we've developed, and we think it's very unique in plant breeding in that we're bringing in the culinary industry into helping us define what is exceptional in terms of fruit quality. And really the overall goal is to marry high quality with all of our agronomic traits that keep our growers profitable.
As a chef, I look for quality, I look for freshness, and above all, I look for taste. So if you're picking a strawberry straight from the vine and it's not traveling a great distance, then you're guaranteed the quality and the freshness. At Johnson & Wales, we teach our students to source the best quality in all products. So working as a team with NC State, the local farmers and Johnson & Wales students, hopefully we'll get the taste right and it'll be a fabulous strawberry.
So in North Carolina, the industry is roughly about 1,800 acres. It's about a $21 million industry. That's a farm gate value, but it also generates lots of jobs and keeps farm families on the farm, keeps farms green and not paved. And so I think the more we can do to support that industry, the better it's going to be in multiple aspects of the state economy.
We've got 80,000 alumni spread throughout the United States and around the world. So they've got great experience. So if you're bringing some of the alumni in to taste test strawberries, then that experience is going to show and hopefully they'll produce a great product.
So with plant breeding, what our ultimate goal is, right, is to create a better plant. We define what better is and we go ahead and implement strategies to do that. And in strawberries, they're a cross-pollinated crop, and so we use traditional breeding methods to take pollen from one parent and place it on to flowers of another parent to hope for that recombination of beneficial attributes from both parents. The crop offers opportunities in conjunction with our environment, and we can go all the way to the western part of the state in high elevation where our climate is very different what it would be like in down east, and it provides us with some opportunities to see a harvest season that can go from 4 weeks potentially to 4 months.
North Carolina ranks fourth in the nation in strawberry production and adds nearly $21 million to the state's economy each year. Experts are hoping to increase that figure by 25%.
I think it's a very important initiative. It's a win-win situation, not only for the students and the alumni, the local farmers and the researchers. A great team working together will produce outstanding results, and hopefully we'll end up with a quality product.
So again, the consumers, I think if we can make a better product for them and have consumption increase, leading to hopefully a healthier population. Fruits and vegetables are very, very good for us, and if we can increase the quality, maybe we can drive consumption as well.
Chefs like to buy local because they know the quality's there, and also we like to buy local to give back to the community. And what better way to buy from your local farmer to reinvest in the community?
We have a really wonderful industry already present in North Carolina, and we have exceptional product from the east to the west. And so what consumers can do now is go find where your local strawberry grower is located and get out on farm and really enjoy what we have to offer right now.
The Newberry won't be available this season, but with a little preparation and know-how, there are still plenty of good North Carolina strawberries you can enjoy right now.
The North Carolina Strawberry Project is supported by the Golden Leaf Foundation.
You can find more information on the Strawberry Project and Chef Mark's recipes at plantsforhumanhealth.ncsu.edu.